Good morning and welcome to St. Ambrose. Our opening song today is number 213, Holy, Holy, Holy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
So today we gather again with the Universal Church to remember and to pray for all the faithful departed, that they may find kind admittance into the heavenly kingdom. So today we decided to light all the candles for all our faithful departed whom we are praying for. And I see we still have a few candles. Anybody who has not lit a candle for somebody? Okay. So Janet, light all of them for on behalf of Beth and anybody else. We have it right there. The lighter should be there. And now let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your departed servants, that with mortality of this life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, their Creator and Redeemer, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth. For the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
The words to our responsory, "My shepherd is the Lord, there is nothing I shall want."
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together and with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. Although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
So we continue to reflect on our destiny, on our ultimate destiny, which is heaven. And I would like to begin with a little joke about heaven. That it was a busy day in heaven, and Peter was having a hard time keeping the tabs on all the newcomers, and he notices across the room Jesus looking really confused. So Peter walks over to Jesus and says, "My Lord, what is wrong?" Jesus replies to Peter, "Peter, where are all these people coming from?" "Oh yeah, that?" Peter says, as he scratches his head. He tells Jesus, "I locked the gates like you asked me, but your mom keeps opening the windows and letting people in." The role of the Blessed Virgin Mary. When you read the litany of Our Lady, one of the attributes is gate of heaven, right? So that is why you see this picture over here. Mary is a very powerful intercessor. And she has a lot of power too, and influence. So that is why she could open the windows for those who are struggling to come in, and brings them in. In many instances during this month, or during All Souls Day, I've made a point of visiting the cemeteries, and I like to read the inscriptions which people put on the, what do you call the stone there? Yeah, gravestone. Yeah, it is very interesting to see the kind of messages people leave right there. There was this one which read like this: "Where you are, I was. Where I am, you will be. Life is short. Live graciously." Then there was this other one. Somebody had inscribed, "Service to others is the rent you pay for your room in heaven." So it is a reminder that we are still on a journey and we have not yet arrived. We are headed to our destiny, which is heaven. So it reminds us that we still have some work to do as we prepare ourselves on that road towards heaven. That is where all of us are expecting to be. So for those who have gone before us, we keep praying for them, because we are told that after this life, we are not very sure at what state a person died. So if you die in a state of grace, that is, then you go to heaven directly. But if there was any stain, then you'll need some purification. And the people who are still in this pilgrim church, who are still alive, help those who have gone before us in their process of purification, that period may not be long for them to arrive at their desired destiny, which is heaven. So when we talk about purgatory, it's not a filter for those who will go to hell or heaven. They are on the road to heaven. We know that. But now, through our prayers, we help them, that process, to move quite fast. So from our first reading today, we heard about the beautiful image of the mountain of the Lord, where he has prepared a banquet of rich food for all peoples. And on that mountain, there will be no mourning, and God will wipe away the tears from every cheek. So that is an image of heaven, that mountain. We pray that the faithful departed are on their way to that mountain. And there is also where we want to go eventually. So that is the mountain of hope, where there is an everlasting celebration of life and love. So our hope is not deceptive, because the love of God has been poured into our hearts by the resurrection of Jesus from the dead. And that is why St. Paul reminds us that when we think of those who have rested, who have fallen asleep, we have to be people of hope. We ought not to be like those who are faithless and are hopeless. We have Jesus Christ. We have to be people of hope and faith. Jesus is our good shepherd, who leads the departed from the valley of death to the mountain of life. And is there inviting us always, "Come to me." That invitation is for all of us. So we have the invitation, we know the destiny. Ours is just to act, and also to help those who have gone before us. There are about five ways to remember the souls of the faithful departed. And you'll realize that in every Mass, during the Eucharistic prayer, we pray for the faithful departed always. So, one way is to offer Mass for the dead. So we offer a Mass to pray for them. We also light a candle, like what we have done this morning. We also pray the novena for the holy souls. So we can also do that, pray a novena for those who have gone before us, our loved ones. Then we visit the cemetery, visit that grave, and make some prayer right over there. We are told that there is an indulgence which is applicable only to the souls in purgatory, which is granted to the faithful who devoutly visit a cemetery and pray for the departed. And this, the full plenary indulgence, you get it within these 8 days, this octave of this month of November, praying for the souls who have, of the faithful departed. So that is another way too, visiting the cemetery. And that is why we have a plan of visiting Mount Olivet on Saturday to pray for all the faithful departed, especially from our parish here. Also praying that eternal rest prayer. We normally pray eternal rest, grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. So when we pray that prayer, eternal rest grant unto them. And we normally also say, rest in peace. What does that rest mean? At times we might think it is a passive thing. Rest, you're just right there. And we pray eternal rest. So from our responsorial Psalm, Psalm 23, it talks about on the restful waters there, where the spirit is kind of enlivened again. So it is not passive. So it's resting with the Lord. So we also pray that prayer of eternal rest, grant unto them, O Lord. Then there's a prayer by St. Gertrude the Great for the holy souls. And it goes like this. Eternal Father, I offer you the most precious blood of your divine Son, Jesus, in union with the Master said throughout the whole world today, for all the souls in purgatory, all sinners everywhere, for sinners in the universal church, those in my own home and within my family, amen. So it's another prayer by St. Gertrude. So those are some of the ways we kind of help in union and communion with those who have gone before us, praying for them. So there is hope through our prayers that there will be the gates of heaven will be opened for them, that one day also we might be united with them in heaven. So let's call to mind all our brothers and sisters, all our friends, all our relatives, and anyone whom you can remember who has gone before us, and lift them up to the Lord during this Mass. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Let us now arise and offer our prayers and our petitions to the Lord.
For the Church, may the Lord shine his light upon her as she stands in the world as a light of hope for all.
Amen.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may the spirit of peace and justice guide their thoughts and actions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or suffering in any way, may the blessing and consolation of our Lord be upon them and give them strength and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may the grace of our union with Christ in both his death and resurrection sustain us in difficult times. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they soon enter the heavenly banquet of our Lord and lie in peaceful rest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased benefactors of St. Ambrose Parish, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us now invite the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our song during the preparation of the gifts, number 477, Shelter Me, O God.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Receive, Lord, in your kindness, the sacrificial offering we make for all your servants who sleep in Christ, that set free from the bonds of death by this singular sacrifice, they may merit eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Ambrose, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Our communion song is number 440, On Eagle's Wings.
So I just want to thank you for coming to celebrate this Mass for our faithful departed. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow again at 9:15 for our usual Friday Mass. And then on Saturday at 11:30, if hopefully the weather will be as good as today, at Mount Olivet. That will be wonderful. Let us now arise and pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your departed servants, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for God's blessing. And the response will be, Amen. May the God of all consolation bless you, for in his unfathomable goodness,
He created the human race, and in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, he has given believers the hope of rising again. Amen. Amen. To us who are alive, may God grant pardon for our sins, and to all the dead, a place of light and peace. Amen. Amen. So may we all live happily forever with Christ, whom we believe truly rose from the dead. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Let us go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 555, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. We'll sing verses 1 and 3.